Hello, today we have another epic battle between three mid-range smartphones. We have Galaxy A55 on the left side, Galaxy A35 in the middle, and Nothing Phone 2A on the right side. They have a bit of a price difference, so Nothing Phone 2A is around 400 for 256GB variant, A35 is around 400, and Galaxy A55 is around 500. So to begin with, I'm gonna put all of them on the same brightness level, and also I'm gonna run an application. On Nothing Phone 2A, I'm gonna turn off the smart 5G, so it is always on 5G and it doesn't cheat. I'm gonna start the test by the AnTuTu benchmark. Just one note, all of them are 5000 mAh battery, so I kind of expect them to have a similar result, but nevertheless, they have different chipsets. So as you can see, Nothing Phone 2A has 68, Galaxy A35 60, and Galaxy A55 have 73 as a point for AnTuTu test. So Galaxy A55 is doing better with the Exynos 1480, A35 is not doing that good with the Exynos 1380, and Nothing Phone 2A is doing almost as good a job as Galaxy A55 with Dimensity 7200. Now I'm gonna run another test. This is the storage test. We want to see how fast the storage is. It's quite important for loading applications. Galaxy A55 again got a better score compared to Nothing Phone 2A. And then the third place is Galaxy A35, which is a bit disappointing considering Galaxy A35 is more expensive than Nothing Phone 2A. Now I'm gonna run another test called 3D Mark. I let both three phones cool down first before running this benchmark. This is a 20-minute test that is gonna test the graphics under stress and load. And you can see the temperatures, 35 degrees for Nothing Phone 35. Galaxy A55 is 98 degrees Fahrenheit, 95 degrees Fahrenheit, and 98 degrees Fahrenheit. As you can see, also the temperature is written there, is the battery temperature that's always visible on Celsius and also on Fahrenheit. A35 is doing a better job compared to A55 and Nothing Phone 2A in terms of thermals. Nothing Phone 2A got the best score, then A55, then Galaxy A35. I turned off all the phones, I went out for a walk, and I came back, and they were like under the sun for quite some time, so the temperatures raised for quite a bit. A55 did the best job, kept it cool by 36 degrees, while Nothing Phone 2A and Galaxy A35 got hotter. As you can see also, like, I tracked the walk for an hour and 7 minutes, and they had a very similar GPS result too. I also took some pictures when I was outdoors, and as you can see, Galaxy A35 and A55, in my opinion, doing a much better job compared to Nothing Phone 2A. Nothing Phone 2A in general put a lot of contrast on the photos. That's not really my taste, and I don't like it that much. If you look at this photo from the nature also, you can see that Nothing Phone 2A added more contrast to the background. The sky is a little bit lighter compared to Galaxy A35 and Galaxy A55, which have a bit of a softer look, if you may. And if you look at these beautiful swans, you can also see that Nothing Phone 2A added a little bit too much contrast in my opinion. Not a big fan of it. Galaxy A55, in my opinion, did the best, followed by Galaxy A35. In general, I don't really like the photos taken by Nothing Phone 2A. I really hope they work on it on the future generations. To start the battery test, I run YouTube on 4K on all three phones. All three phones are right now on Wi-Fi. I noticed that on Nothing Phone 2A, YouTube is on the light mode, whereas in Galaxy A35 and Galaxy A55, it is on the dark mode. That was not intentional. The first test is done. Now we are moving to Google Meet's test. So as you can see, Nothing Phone 2A is at 78. Galaxy A35 and A55 is also at 78%. All of them have the same battery life so far. But Nothing Phone 2A actually got hotter compared to Galaxy A35 and Galaxy A55, which is quite surprising because, you know, we kind of thought that Exynos is not gonna perform that better. If we move to temperature of the body, it is 33 degrees, 35 degrees, and 38 degrees, which is 92 Fahrenheit, 96 Fahrenheit, and 100 Fahrenheit. So Nothing Phone 2A did not do as great job in terms of thermals. Also, I used the app from FLIR to test the temperature. As you can see, the Nothing Phone 2A is hotter than the other two phones. Galaxy A55 did the best job here. Kudos to Samsung for creating such an efficient chipset in terms of thermals. Now I'm gonna turn off Wi-Fi and we are moving to 5G test. All phones are connected to 5G. Nothing Phone 2A is 67, Galaxy A35 the same. Galaxy A55 has 1% more in the tank right now. We are again running YouTube for half an hour before we move on Meets. So then we move on testing the temperature of the display. And as you can see, Galaxy A55 is at 83 Fahrenheit, then 88 Fahrenheit, and 88 Fahrenheit also. Celsius 29, 31 degrees Celsius, and again 31 degrees Celsius. Again, Galaxy A55, they're superior in terms of thermal management. Again, I would like to say that all of them have the same brightness level and the same conditions. Then we moved on Meets on 5G. This is one of the most stressful tests that you can put on a phone. 60%, 60%, 61%, all of them are going shoulder to shoulder, 34 degrees Celsius, 35 degrees Celsius, and 38 degrees Celsius. As you can see, Galaxy A55 again did a better job compared to Galaxy A35 and Nothing Phone 2A. I'm gonna let the phones cool down a bit and I'm gonna do this test for display. As you can see, one of the problems with cheaper Samsung phones is that the display refresh rate is not that nice, so some people may get some headache or become dizzy. As you can see, Nothing Phone 2A refresh rate is much better compared to Galaxy A35 and Galaxy A55. Of course, this is only visible on the camera and on the normal lights, on the normal setting with your normal eye. You cannot really see it, but for some people, they can feel it, and that can be a bit of a problem. Now I'm gonna turn off all the phones and go and sleep at night for like 8 to 9 hours. And in the morning, I'm gonna wake up, see how much battery they used. As you can see, A55 did the best job, then Nothing Phone 2A, and then Galaxy A35. A35 was not that efficient in terms of battery on the standby mode. I then went for one day on cycling and I came back and I continued the test. Now Nothing Phone 2A is at 40%, Galaxy A35 is at 35%, and Galaxy A55 is at 41%. I also increased the brightness on all phones because I kind of was tired of the test, so I wanted to run the batteries more. So Galaxy A55 is again more efficient in terms of thermals, 29 degrees, whereas A35 is 31 degrees, and Nothing Phone 2A is reaching 32 degrees Celsius. I'm playing YouTube Shorts for quite some time. Now I'm moving to the camera test. I'm using the front camera on the same resolution. Nothing Phone 2A dropped to 31, Galaxy A35 dropped to 23%, and Galaxy A55 dropped to 30% battery life. So it seems like Galaxy A55 is going to win, but let's not conclude it too soon. I don't think Galaxy A35 is gonna catch up with Nothing Phone 2A or A55. So the main battle is between Galaxy A55 and Nothing Phone 2A. 21%, 14%, 21%. Nothing Phone 2A is very close to Galaxy A55, which kind of shows here. Before we go to the last stage of the test, let's look at the power consumption chart. As you can see, on the x-axis we have time and y-axis power. As you can see, they are very close. Nothing Phone 2A average consumption is 2, A55 1.9, and A35 is also 1.9. All of them used almost similar power. On the temperature side, as you can see, Nothing Phone 2A has a much higher average compared to A55 and A35. It is around 1 degree Celsius on average higher than the other phones. Again, A55 did the best. Now we move to some other tests to just run the batteries to the ground. Basically, Galaxy A35 is at 9%, Nothing Phone 2A is at 17%, and Galaxy A55 is at 16%. So now I'm gonna put all phones on the dark mode because I feel it's not very fair to Nothing that the YouTube is running on the light mode, which is in turn gonna use more battery. So all of them are gonna run on the dark mode for the rest of the test. I speed up things for you. Things are gonna get very exciting. So Galaxy A55 is at 12%, Nothing Phone 2A is at 14%, and Galaxy A35 is at 3% battery left. I think Galaxy A35 is gonna soon finish the battery life, And yes, at 6 hours and 4 minutes exact, Galaxy A35 said goodbye to the team. Now the main battle is between Galaxy A55 and Nothing Phone 2A. Galaxy A55 has 9% battery left and Nothing Phone 2A has also 9% battery left. But Galaxy A55 kind of dropped at the end. This is like Samsung, typical Samsung, like, you know, at the end of a test, usually the battery under 10% just drops like butter cutting through knife. And Galaxy A55 seems like losing the battle to Nothing Phone 2A. And yes, at 6 hours and 43 minutes and 7 seconds, A55 also lost the battle to Nothing Phone 2A. Now, Nothing Phone 2A already established the first place. The question is like, by what a margin? It seems like the last few percentage on Nothing Phone 2A is gonna last for quite a bit, which is quite interesting. So Nothing 2A wins another 40 minutes and lost the battle at 7 hours and 35 minutes. So the conclusion is that A55 has the best performance and also has the best thermals. Then the second performance is for Nothing 2A and the third performance is for Galaxy A35. In terms of battery life, Nothing Phone 2A won the game, followed by A55 and then A35. Camera is a bit subjective, but I personally prefer A55 over A35 and Nothing Phone 2A. Thanks for watching the video. If you like this video, you're also gonna like the comparison of A35 versus A55 in a day in the real life. And also you are gonna like the Galaxy A35 versus A55 versus S24 in terms of battery life. Thanks for tuning into Tecmo. Until the next one, bye.